Well, 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 how is it going? Today I am going to teach you a very simple technique that I use to create a space background or a sky full of stars background. So, in the Blender Render Engine, go to the World tab. Check the Blend Sky and Real Sky checkboxes. Set the zenith and ambient colors as black. Set the horizon colors RGB values as shown here. Now that this is all set up, all that is missing are the actual stars, right? The creation of the stars is a very easy process. Well then, let's make this happen. First, divide the screen like this. Activate the display render preview mode so you can see the changes that you will make. Open the node editor. Set it to texture nodes and select the world data option. Now, click this button to create a new texture. Check the use nodes checkbox. As you can see, you have a standard checker texture. You will notice it is really dark in the rendered view. Let's change that. Go to the texture tab. Check horizon, under the influence options, and add check blend. Everything looks much clearer now. You have this as your default texture. I will show you how to turn this into this. Don't worry, I will explain everything. Leave your output node, but delete the checker node. The first node that you need to add is the Stussy node. Set these options exactly as you see here. Set the size to 0.003 and turbulence to 60. If you don't know how to add the Stussy node, this is how you do it. The second node that you are going to need is the color ramp node. Connect the color output of the Stussy node to the factor input of the color ramp node. For the left slider in this node, set the color to black and the alpha to 0. Set the position as 0.960. The second slider will be set at position 0.990 with a white color and alpha 1. This is enough to create stars, but they will lack color. The color will be added by this lower node segment. This will create clusters of red stars and blue stars, which will be mixed in the final result. Notice the red stains surrounded by blue stains. I don't know if you can see it, but there are clusters of blue and red stars, clearly divided. Anyway, I will show you how to do this. So, add a default musgrave texture node. Then, add a mix RGB node. You add this node the same way as the other nodes. Set the first color as red and the second color as blue. Leave the blending as mix. Don't forget to connect the musgrave's color output to the mix factor. Now, create two more mix RGB nodes. Set the blend mode of the second one to add. Set the factor values as shown. Connect the red and blue color mix as the second color of the two new mix nodes. connect the color amp output as the first color of the same nodes. Notice that this second node contains many variations of white, blue and red stars. This happens because it is adding the red and blue colors to the white stars that come from the color amp node. This first node has the more saturated red and blue star clusters, but lacks the white stars. The last mix RGB node is set to the lighten blend mode. This means that it will pick the brightest color for every individual star. Set the factor to 1. As you can see, the result is a bunch of bright stars of varying colors. Okay, now let me show you something. Normally, galaxies have a bright horizon. This phenomenon is caused by the high concentration of stars that condense due to gravitational forces. The brighter the horizon, the thicker your galaxy will seem. The deep and dark space represents the empty space outside of the galaxy. You can change the horizon colors, depending on the color of the galaxy. A very old galaxy would be red in color. For example, you can create multiple effects with the horizon color alone. Later, you can also add some extra textures, such as a nebula and galaxies in the distance. You can also create a sky texture using these methods. Notice the contrast between the total darkness of empty space and the horizon of the galaxy. Okay, so did you see how easy it was to create a simple stars in space type scene with just a few notes? What else can you do with it? If you find a better or easier way, let me know in the comments. Anyway, if you found this video to be helpful, like it and subscribe. I will be sharing more quick tips and tutorials whenever I discover new techniques. If you have any question about any animation related technique, ask away. See you around.